That's bad.
I have been waiting for this day since I first laid eyes on this car in person. I'm so excited. Pops is coming over with the trailer. We're gonna get this thing loaded up, take it over to his place, because today is the day we get started on painting this thing. Now, I know that there's some of you guys who really like the blue. I'm not one of them. So we're going to completely repaint the car. We're gonna sand it down, prime it, paint it. We're not going to go for like show car quality. It's a race car at the end of the day. But we are going to do the best we can to try to make this thing look a little bit nicer. Hopefully that wind's not too bad for you guys. It's outside. It's a really nice day out, so trying to be outside as much as possible. There was a few colors that I was torn between when I was trying to think of what color to paint this thing, because it needs a paint job. I think a paint job will make this thing just that much better. So I was trying to think of what colors, and I was really torn between three. I was torn between a gloss black. Didn't really want to do flat black. There's a bunch of flat black cars. I was torn between white. I think white cars look great. One of my favorite colors on cars. And the third one I was thinking about was just nice classy red. So you can see a little bit like right here, this car originally was red before the original guy who built it and back halved it put it in a wall. And then the guy I got it from fixed the bodywork and painted it this robin egg blue. So let me know in the comments below what color you think we went with. And we'll get this thing loaded up and head on over. And I'm also curious, if this was your car, what color would you have painted it?
Oh. And look who just arrived.
Perfect timing. Yeah, that's probably good. Got it loaded up, strapped down.
I can't wait to see this thing once it's done, man. This thing's gonna look killer. Get them wheels polished. Oh, baby.
Let me grab the paint and primer. So hopefully the next time you guys see the Starfire, it'll be looking perfect. And now for the rest of the video, let's turn our attention to the RX-7. I had someone comment on the previous video. They wanted me to go over just the setup in the car and like how much it's cost and stuff like that. And I said, sure, yeah, I can probably do that in this video real quick. So real quick, there's a lot of unnecessary stuff on this car. It's still fairly budget, but things like the intake weren't really necessary. It was just total impulse that I had to have. It's just one of those things I just wanted, you know? So as far as like how much I actually have into the car, maybe while I'm editing and I'm talking about things, I'll throw up the actual number, because a lot of this stuff I don't remember offhand. But I'll try to just kind of go with some of the basics. So the car itself I bought as a shell in Detroit, and it was $400, I think. It was $300 or $400. I think it was $400. And so I'm going to start with just the like necessary stuff to get it to like where you could just slap it together and go about as fast as this thing does, because it's, like I said, a real basic setup. So it is a iron block 5.3 that I'll admit I paid way too much for. Well, actually, technically this thing I got for free, because I bought it for $600 and then sold it to my buddy Chris, and then he traded it back to me on labor for swapping motors in one of his trucks. So basically I got it for free. And it now has a Howard's cam in it, which, I mean, basically any LS cam, if you're buying like a Texas Speed or BTR, or I'm assuming the Howards are the same ones, most of them are going to be $400. So I know like the LS motors, they vary a lot depending on where you are in the country. I see a lot of people saying that they can't find even a 4.8 for less than $1,000, which, that's just psychotic. A basic 5.3. This one does have flat top pistons in it, so that's where the boosted compression comes from. But a basic 5.3 you can pick up for, let's just say, $500. I think that's a pretty fair price for a complete one that they pull out of a truck if you don't want to go to the junkyard and pull it yourself. So we'll say $500 there, $400 for the cam. That's $900. And then you're going to need valve springs. Those are, depending on the ones you want, like in this case, I've got the pack 1218s. Those are $160, I think. So we're at $1060. The RX-7 is a really limited platform as far as like fitment. So that's why a lot of the stuff that I did, if you're putting it in like a G-body, it's not necessary. You can run the truck water pump. This is an F-body water pump. You can run the truck accessories and stuff like that. And if you don't want to run the power steering, you can just pull it off and use the bracket. So like this ICT bracket and the water pump and everything, that's like $200, give or take. I believe this is just a eBay water pump too. It's not even like a real parts store one. So we're at, let's say, $1,300. And then this turbo is a Billet 7875 from VS Racing. This one I got on sale for $500, I think. $550 maybe. So that puts us at about $1,900, I think, if I'm doing my math right. And then the injectors, these are Snake Eater 1500s. I want to say these are $400 or $500, which you can actually get them a lot cheaper if you use code SNYDERTRON for 10% off your order at Snake Eater Performance. Hell yeah. This is all just either Summit or Amazon AN fittings and AN line. I've used it a lot, never had any issues with it. As long as you make sure you blow it out when you're done and take your time putting it together. Don't get anything messed up. It's always worked great. Stock coils, stock valve covers, stock heads, stock valves. And then in my case, this intake with the intercooler and everything, $2,000. Thank goodness for credit cards and payments. Because this, it looks awesome and it works really well, but like a TBSS in meth injection would do the same thing and save hundreds, even $1,000+. So in this setup, I've got, where'd I leave off? There's a spider on my intake. What you doing, little brother? So in this case, I've got, like 4,000 into the motor, give or take. The converter I've got in this car is a TSI spragless converter that I got from my buddy Scott, who you saw his truck in his brother's car in the last video. I got that on trade from him, which it's an amazing converter. I got a sweet deal on it. And then wrapped around that converter is a Power Glide transmission built by Tony at Mid Michigan Transmission. And the thing has not missed a beat, knock on wood, but that thing has been awesome, which is the only reason I haven't torn it apart to put a trans brake in. It's just, it works so well, I don't want to mess it up. And then I obviously had to have a drive shaft made. That was about $400. And then we've got a Ford 8.8 in the back here, which I did do a video showing me cutting it down so that it fits the car. If you buy one out of like an Explorer, it has one side offset, so you can cut it and put two passenger side axles in it. And it's the perfect width. That I got for, I want to say, $120 from a junkyard, and then cut it down myself. And the shop I used to work at in Clarkston, Michigan, Line to Line Coatings, a couple of my buddies still worked there, so I got it powder coated for free. And then I just had to make some four link bars, which are all in the stock location, which is why my geometry is super messed up. I had to make a panhard bar. That's worked out great. I think like a real safe bet, the way the car sits now, is I've got, oh, including the Holley Terminator X, which was $1,000 at the time. Now I think it's $1,100 or $1,150. The wheels were $700. The front brakes, I really only put these on here to get like a real easy bolt-on five lug swap. But the brakes are amazing. I know people have commented on the squealing in the last few videos. That's because the car, I street drive it a lot, and the people at Aerospace, because this is an Aerospace Components front brake kit, they said these rotors aren't meant for street driving. They'll get really hot and they'll start to glaze the pads. So there's tons of life left on the pads. They still look almost brand new. They're just glazed over. So at some point I have to pull them off. They said hit it with some 80 grit and then spray the back with some of this stuff, three coats, and they said you'll be good to go. So that's the only reason they've been squealing in the last few videos. So the brakes themselves are amazing. They stop the car perfectly. Just a little noisy right now. But those were $800. So I'm gonna try and do some quick math here real quick. Let's see, 500. Oh, and the fuel system, I forgot about that. So I have two AEM 400 pumps.
Hopefully you can see them there.
And they work perfect. Those are rated for more than this thing will ever make. So give or take 10,000, to be honest. I mean, it was spent a little bit at a time aside from the intake, but stuff just adds up. I mean, I've been putting the car together for I think 3 years, so. And there's still a few things I wanna change on it. Like I would like to back half the car. Probably this winter, maybe, perhaps. I don't know. And then it's gonna need, obviously, more cage. I know that. I'm not stupid. I know that it needs more cage. The brakes are actually really good, just the squealing, like I said. So I'd like to back half the car, probably this winter, have a cage put in it, like a good chromoly cage. Just a nice little, like, 850s cage. Trans brake. Even though this thing, I'm starting to get it figured out. I got it building boost pretty quickly on the two-step on the foot brake. And here, I'll just show you guys before we end the video. But yeah, like I said, someone asked about this, so I figured I'd go over it a little bit because I don't remember the last time I did it. Like I said, we're starting to get things figured out with it. Still have to add the second wastegate. Hopefully that'll be here in a couple days. And then we can take this thing out and start seeing what it'll do. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing, clicking that bell. I'll see you next time.